were especially fascinated with the most mysterious invisible force of all, magnetism.
The result of their fascination was the creation of the world's first magnetic compass. This was called a synon, a section of lodestone, which is naturally magnetic, was carved into the shape of the Big Dipper and placed on a polished board. The circular center of the board represented heaven, and the square represented earth, and the spoon, the Big Dipper. This constellation was especially sacred, as two stars in the Big Dipper always point to the pole star. The emperor was the earthly counterpart of the pole star, around which all the other stars rotated. The master himself, Confucius, said, "He who governs virtuously may be compared to the polar star, which keeps its place as the other stars turn around it." All visitors to the emperor had to sit to his south so that the stars could rotate around his head. Therefore, officials around the emperor were seen as inhabiting the constellations rotating around the polar star. And so the synon was a mystical instrument used not for navigation, but as a tool for geomancy, or feng shui. Feng shui is a technique for aligning cities and houses harmoniously with the earth's forces. Forces detected with the aid of this compass. The synon evolved into more complex feng shui compasses, which are still in use today. Hundreds of years before the first compass was to be found on a European ship, small factories in China mass-produced a variety of compass designs. The world's first prototype of the dry modern navigational compass was called the magnetic turtle. South was indicated by the direction of the needle, which was attached to a magnet concealed inside the model. Around the year 850 AD, Chinese ships began to carry a water compass to help them navigate during murky weather and storms, when there was no way to use the sun or the stars. This simple mariner's compass would always point south, unlike modern compasses today.
I'm Kyle, and I'm going to be presenting the topic, compass. How do you think this compass was used, Eva?
Was it a tool?
Good try. Mom?
It looks like it was some kind of eating, like chicken soup utensil.
Good try. I know what you're thinking, navigation. But it was really used for geomancy, which we'll learn about later. The first compass was called a synon. Its main use was geomancy, a magical technique for aligning buildings with Earth's forces. The handle of the spoon pointed south because of magnetism. Iron fish and wooden turtle compasses. These are later compass construction techniques. The iron fish was constructed by pulling iron into a fish shape and then placing it into water. The head pointed south because of magnetism. The wooden turtle compass. It was made by carving wood into a turtle shape. Then, a magnet needle was placed in the back of the turtle, which pointed south.
That's strange.
Feng shui / geomancy. This is the main use of older compasses. Geomancers / feng shui practitioners use special compasses to orient buildings in lucky directions. Believe when buildings were in this direction, that it would bring good fortune to people. This is the main use of newer compasses. Geomancy is more important to the Chinese people than navigation for older ones. But the early compasses did help Chinese find jade, though. When the compasses were used for navigation, it gave the Chinese the advantage to navigate no matter what the weather was.
even enlightening?